All right, welcome, hello. Today we're going to talk about wind classification to AS4055. This code, it does have a number of other sections later on which talk about pressures and coefficients on different members, but we're not going to go into that. We're just going to talk about the first section, which is just the wind classification itself. So very basic, just some who, what, when, where's. What is it? It's essentially a simplified, boiled-down version of 1170. For those of you who are familiar with both, you'll see that there's definitely some similarities between them, and you can see how they derived 4055 from 1170. They both use, I guess, the same sort of environmental factors that impact on wind speed. So your shielding, your topography, your terrain. Who uses it? Well, we do. Engineers, designers, architects, builders and manufacturers in the residential sector. So truss manufacturers, glazing, that sort of thing. Everyone uses it. What do you use it for? You classify different housing sites into one of 10 different bracketed wind categories. And as you know, once we get speed, it leads to pressures. We can get our forces, and then from there, that's where we can do our design. Once we have the forces, we can do our bracing and our members and connections. And why do we use it? Well, as you'll see later, it's faster, way faster than 1170, and it's still reasonably accurate. So just when and where you can use it. It's only applicable to class 1 and 10 buildings as defined in the NCC. And in addition to that, there's also some geometric limits that have been applied, which, as I was saying before, with the coefficient section and pressures, they've applied those assumptions of geometric factors to the building so that it simplifies all those pressures. A lot of wording here. I don't want to basically read the code out to you, but essentially a 16 meter max width, a length of a maximum of 5 times whatever width you have, and a 8.5 meter roof height. So I guess the main ways that you wouldn't, that a normal house would probably fail to these geometric limits would be the height. It'd be pretty hard to have a house that long, but maybe a really skinny block and still try and have a really, really long house, 40 meters and 7 meters wide, that'd fail and you'd have to go to 1170. And a max roof pitch of 35. So how the process works, as I said before, you're trying to determine 4 separate metrics, and then you apply them into table 2.2 of the code, and they give you an overall wind category. So first of all, the easiest one is the wind region, and you've got a choice of 4, and we'll go into that later. Terrain category, choice of 5, shielding class, and topographic class. And these two here are really the ones that set 4055 apart from 1170 in terms of simplicity. In 1170, you've got a whole bunch of equations to determine these, where in 4055, it's just a table, and you're just picking the most suitable metric. So wind region, it's all based off this map, very easy. You just pick where you are on that site. So region A covers the majority of the area of Australia and probably the majority of the population as well, Sydney and Melbourne. Brisbane is the only capital city that's not in it. The next one up, region B, is anywhere within 100 kilometres of the coast north of 30 degrees latitude. Region C is anywhere north of 25 and within 50 kilometres of the coast. And then region D, which we don't normally get into in Queensland, is over in Western Australia, and it's in this area here. So the terrain category, these are actually, I think, more or less exactly the same as the terrain category set out in AS 1170. So your first two are really for sites that are adjacent to water. So we do some work with that, but more commonly we're dealing with these bottom three. So terrain cat 2, I like to think, is just the middle of a cane paddock. You've got essentially no obstructions whatsoever around the site to slow down the wind speed. Terrain Cat 3 is the other end of the scale, so built up, developed areas, so around Brisbane, where we are now, Hendra, Chermside, Camp Hill, just built up suburban areas, and then 2.5, logically it's just somewhere in between. So acreage kind of sites, Bridgman Downs, that sort of thing. So the topographic classification, it's still probably the hardest part of 4055, but it's a lot more simple than the 1170 way. First step, you're just figuring out where your site is on the hill. Is it the lower, mid, or top third? If you're in the lower third, you can stop there and move on, because it's T0, which is the lowest severity, all the way down. It doesn't matter how steep the hill gets. Mid third, even on a very steep, you're still only getting to T2, so it's not a huge concern. Being in the top third, that's when you've got to look into it a bit more. And then from there, you're wanting to know the max slope on the hill, and it's important to note that that's through the top half of the hill, which can catch you out. If you're doing it through the whole hill, it may be that the bottom half's very, very slight slope, and it's going to average out your slope to not as severe, and you might end up putting yourself in the wrong category. And then shielding, again, this is a lot more simple than 1170. No equations, it's just three categories and just some definitions. So full shielding is two rows of houses or house-shaped objects in regions A and B, so you can use large trees as shielding in regions A and B. Two rows all sides, so if you were to have 100 houses to the east, 100 houses to the west, 100 to the south, but nothing on the north, you'd have to go with no shielding in that case. Partial is one row each side, and no is none. And so then at the end, you put all those together. This is table 2.2 I spoke about before. So you get your region, terrain cat, your slope, and then your shielding factor, and you pick your overall wind classification. Some interesting things to note is that N1, the lowest, you can't get that in region B, so you can't get an N1 in Queensland. And we hasn't really come into my work yet, but region D is definitely more severe, where you're getting into this non-applicable area, even at sort of T1. So it's just a difference on the region C, which you're not getting non-applicable outside the scope until you're getting very, very steep slopes. So again, I want to stress, I've really just hit on the main points. If you go into read 4055, there's a lot more detail, explanation, there's commentary, examples as well in the appendix of how to use all these different clauses. Because you will find that when you go into it, it's sometimes hard to make a decision when you're not familiar with it. And again, if classification is not possible, whether due to geometric non-compliance, or it's not a class 110, or it just falls outside that previous table and you're up here in the NA, you need to go to 1170 to get a really specific calculation of wind speed. So I've kind of run through all the process there, but we'll just do a couple of examples now, which will hopefully put it into better context. So I found this on Google Maps. I just scrolled around until I found an empty block, 10 Tabinga Street, Wavell Heights. It's this nice aqua zone here. Must have been a house, and it's cleared, but it's a clear block on Google Maps now anyway. So if we were to go through the process, it's region B, it's in Brisbane. Definitely terrain cat 3, as we can see. It's a very suburban environment, built up for sure. When I looked into the contours, I've come up with a topographic classification of T1. It's in the top third of only a small hill, 10 metres, but it's in the top third, and it's 5 degrees. Full shielding we can apply to this. There's at least two houses in each direction, and even to the south here, we've got a very large tree, which in region A and B we can use as shielding. So if we go back to our magic table here and put all those together, region B, terrain cat 3, T1, and full shielding. N2. So we'll just do another example to show how that terrain cat can affect. This site, 773 Stock Route Road, Palmyra. It's northern Queensland, so it's Region C. That terrain is, as I said, cane paddock, so terrain cat 2. It's a pretty flat area, but I think this site might be on the only hill in the area. It's turned out to be T2. It's in the top third, right at the top of a 30 metre hill, less than 30, at 9.5 degrees. And clearly no shielding could be applied to that site either. So if you go through all that, you come up with C3. Finally, I just thought we should do a little bit of a comparison to AS1170. So that previous site, 773 Stock Route Road, I actually did for a job, did a portal frame shed there, and used 1170 to classify it. So going through the process with these inputs, I've come up with 68 meters per second as my design ultimate wind speed. And as we just said, we came up with C3 previously, which corresponds to a wind speed of 74. So what you'll find is if you use it correctly, 4055, and you don't get it wrong, it's never going to put you in a category where your wind speed is lower than what you would get using 1170. So it's always conservative or just about right, but it's never going to put you in a category where you're actually designing for a wind speed that's too slow. So there we go. Thanks for listening. Hope you learned maybe one thing there or just brushed up on the basics there, but that's my rundown of AS4055.